Do you guys think there is something they can do to salvage this and win this series? Is there a window? 15% of teams that have been in this situation have done it.
How about coming to get the ball out of LeBron James' hands? I mean, when a great player has it going like that, don't leave your defender out on just one guy trying to guard that. I'm like, come on, man. I feel bad for whoever's trying to guard him, especially when he had it going.
You mean the rookie, OG Anunoby, like, should not have been left on that island?
Pascal Siakam, too.
You got to get the ball out of LeBron's hand.
But there is a big question. I mean, coaches have been facing this for 15 years. He's a really good passer, and they have surrounded him with shooters. You go double LeBron, you're leaving someone open.
You got to live with that.
Right.
I mean, I'd rather for him to pass the ball to guys that pretty much have been inefficient. And then him hitting shots like the way he was last night.
The game plan wasn't flawed because LeBron's supporting cast hasn't been great.
From the Raptors' standpoint, like, this is why, first of all, it's a bad matchup, you know, for them, that they got the number one seed and Cleveland fell to the number four seed. Like, that was all bad for them. But you take their two players, and I love Kyle, I love DeRozan. To me, they haven't elevated that game. Playoff mode right now, it still feels like they're in regular season mode. Like, you have to take your game to another level. LeBron is doing it. Like, great players take their game to another level. Right now, I'm not seeing that.
They gotta be like Terry Rozier. I mean, clearly, that's the mantra of the entire NBA right now.
And,
or Donovan Mitchell and so many other players.
DeRozan and Lowry's stats are good. They're not having bad games per se.
No, they're not.
But they're not impacting the game, which is what you need to do.
Okay.